Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about body fluid compartments, or in simple words, distribution of water in our body. So let's get started. In a normal adult male of 70 kilograms of weight, about 60% of body weight is water. That is, a 70 kilo man has 42 liters of water in his body. However, this percentage differs depending on age, gender, and other conditions. Like, in newborn babies, water makes up to 70 to 75% of total body weight. On the other hand, in old age, this percentage decreases even below 60%. The reason for this decrease is the increased percentage of fat. Even adult women also have a greater percentage of fat than men. Their total body water averages about 50% of their body weight. And as you can guess by now, even in adult male who are obese, the percentage of water is less than that in men who are not obese. Thus, the percentage of body water varies depending on these factors. Now, of course, this water is not present as a single bag of fluid inside your body. It is distributed in different compartments. Broadly, these compartments are called intracellular compartment and extracellular compartment. First, let's talk about the intracellular fluid compartment. We have about 100 trillion cells in our body, and they all have fluid inside. Thus, in the literal sense, we have 100 trillion tiny intracellular fluid compartments. But the thing is, the composition of fluid in all the cells is almost the same. So all these tiny compartments are collectively considered a big single intracellular fluid compartment. The total fluid in all the cells is about 28 liters. This is 40% of total body weight and about 2/3 of the body fluid. So this was about the intracellular fluid compartment. Now let's talk about the extracellular fluid. As the name suggests, this is the fluid outside the cells. Here we have two sub-compartments. One is the interstitial fluid and the other is plasma. The interstitium is the space in between the cells. The total volume of such fluid in all over the body is about 11 liters. The plasma is free fluid in the blood. If you don't know, the blood has blood cells like red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets, and free fluid which is called plasma. The total volume of blood is about 5 liters. Out of that, the cells take about 2 liters of volume. Earlier when I said that the intracellular fluid is about 28 liters, that included these 2 liters of blood cells too. Thus we can say the volume of cells in all the other tissues combined is about 26 liters. In blood, the remaining is plasma, which is 3 liters. This plus 11 liters of interstitial fluid makes a total of about 14 liters of extracellular fluid. This is about 20% of total body weight and about 1/3 of the total body water. Now, the capillary wall is highly permeable. So both these fluids are continuously mixing with each other. So they have almost the same composition. The main difference is in protein concentration. The capillary wall is not so permeable to proteins. So the proteins mostly stay in the plasma only. So they have a much higher concentration in plasma. So this was about extracellular fluid compartment. Finally, one more point before we see the summary. Apart from the fluid in the tissues, we also have fluid in body cavities like synovial cavity, peritoneal cavity, pericardial cavity, intraocular space, space in the brain and spinal cord, etc. The fluid in these spaces is called transcellular fluid. Their composition may differ from plasma and interstitial fluid. Collectively, they constitute about 1 to 2 liters. So this was all about body fluids. Now let's have a quick summary. A normal healthy male of 70 kilograms weight has 60%, that is 42 liters of water in his body. This percentage varies depending on age, gender, etc. Intracellular fluid volume is about 28 liters. This includes the volume of blood cells as well. The extracellular fluid volume is about 14 liters. This includes 11 liters of interstitial fluid and 3 liters of plasma. Transcellular fluid is fluid in body cavities like peritoneal cavity, intraocular space, etc. Now, for sticking with me until the end, here is a bonus point for you. Among all these fluids, plasma is the main medium for all kind of exchanges between the compartments. Like when you drink water, its absorption adds it to the plasma first. Then from here, it is distributed to all over the body. Similarly, the point of contact for kidneys to collect the waste products is the plasma only. Even the drugs given by intravenous route also enters the plasma first. That's it for this video. Please take a moment to hit the like button and comment if you can spare a few more seconds. Sharing this video with your friends will be awesome. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.